to what it is, to how it'll affect us, and whether Earth honestly has anything to worry about and more. Join us as we reveal to you how a mega comet is approaching from the Oort cloud. So let's get right to it, shall we? What exactly is going on, and why should we as humans care? A huge comet so large it's classified as a minor planet has been spotted beyond Uranus, coming into the inner solar system for once in a 600,000-year visit. It's known as the Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein, and it's got a lot of people talking about it because of how close it's believed to get by the end of its run. When is the end of its run? Well, that's honestly one piece of good news. Despite it being half a light year away, it still won't reach the end point of its run until 2031. Yes, we have a decade to watch this thing coming, which is good for various reasons, but not the least of which is that its trajectory is something that is changing a lot of people's perceptions about it. It was first discovered about 29 astronomical units, AU, away from the Sun in our solar system. For context, Earth is 1 AU from the Sun and Neptune is 30 AU. Hence, Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein's initial classification as a trans-Neptunian object, TNO, which is defined as a minor planet or dwarf planet in the solar system that orbits the Sun at a greater average distance than Neptune. According to the latest observations from Les Cumbres Observatory, Sutherland in South Africa, it's now about 20 AU from the Sun, which is outside the orbit of Saturn, and that means it's moving and might just be moving towards us. Which is a problem because apparently, though not confirmed, the comet is said to be about 62 miles in diameter, which is more than enough to wipe out the planet should it hit us. Keyword here being should, because on its current path it's not projected to hit the Earth. So where is it going? To put it simply, it's going on the path it's always been on. Comets like these, one of which you know via Halley's Comet, are known to have what are called long orbits. They take their sweet time going around in an orbit around the Sun. While the origins of this one is unknown, based on its speed and the orbit path, some scientists state that its path takes 600,000 years to do so. That's a long orbit. Like all comets, this one will round the Sun and head off back to where it came from. But the closest it will get to the Sun will be 10.5 AU. And while it may come close-ish to the Earth, we're again not in any danger of it hitting. The comet is believed to come from the Oort cloud that exists in our solar system, which, of course, a major location that is said to house many other comets and similarly important items. And we don't say that lightly because it's one of the most mysterious parts of our universe. The fact that the comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein's path was a mystery to us until now more or less proves once more that we honestly don't know as much about our own backyard in space like we think. Now, ironically, despite the comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein not coming close enough to Earth, most agree that it won't get beyond the orbit of Jupiter, there are indeed plans to try and actually go to it and perhaps get a sample of it. The reasoning behind this? Well, first off, it's a special ice entity from a spot in space that we can't reach outside of probes like the Voyagers, and thus can't examine willy-nilly. Second, if we can't get a chunk of it for research, we have the potential to go and examine it and then determine what else might be out there in the Oort cloud. It can also help us determine the true origins of the comet and certain other things about space as a whole. The problem? As you might have guessed, getting something to the area of Saturn isn't that easy, even prep time. So in this case, the team that is honestly seeing whether they can do this would go and make the launch of the probe or satellite or entity that they're going to send at this comet in 2029. Yes, a full 2 years before the comet reaches its apex of the journey in terms of how close it'll get to Earth. Saturn, as noted earlier, is quite a bit away from Earth, and even if we advance things like rocket propulsion by 2029, it's still going to be quite a distance to go. Not to mention they'd have to land on it safely. Not an easy feat. Then get a sample, probably the easiest part of the job, and then get back safely to Earth with the sample intact, another not-so-easy feat. So then the question becomes, do we try and wait for another comet like this to come closer to Earth? That might honestly be the path towards getting an easier sample. And if you look at the history of comets in recent times, you're going to see that some rather interestingly sized comets have gotten close enough to Earth to make some realize that there might just be a chance to study them sooner rather than later. But to study one of this size, that's another story. We'll just have to wait and see what this icy piece does in the next 10 years, and whether we'll get a better chance to observe it before it turns around. Before we continue, be sure to like or dislike the video. That way we can continue to make the best content possible for you, the viewer. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Of course, more than likely, you're thinking about one thing when you hear that a massive comet is headed our way. And that is the fact that if it was to come our way, we'd be screwed, right? Well, more than likely. Yes, we would. First and foremost, the size of this particular comet is very disconcerting. After all, it's 62 miles across and no doubt very heavy. Remember, force equals mass times acceleration. Sure, it'll be kind of slow if it was to hit Earth, especially after burning up a bit in the atmosphere. But when it hits, the word boom would not be an apt enough description for the destruction that it would cause. Some out there might go, but what if it fell into the ocean? What might seem like a best case scenario, but in truth, not so much. Think about it like this. Where are all the oceans? Situated between or next to massive or small pieces of land. The Pacific is between Asia and the Americas, as well as Australia. The Atlantic is in between the Americas, Africa, and Europe. The Indian Ocean is wedged between three different continents, and so on and so forth. A 62-mile-long comet hitting any part of the ocean, even perfectly centered between some of those landmasses, is going to cause massive destruction for one simple reason: tidal waves. Yeah, exactly. The moment that impact lands, the waters of the area are going to rise up and go out in all directions. We all know the terrifying power of tsunamis that have been caused by earthquakes. Now imagine that happening on an even bigger scale. Any small island that is in the path of those waves will be wiped out. The various coastlines of the continents near where the comet hits, that would be drowned in water, and even when the water recedes, the levels of the ocean will make it so that the maps will need to be redrawn. And that says nothing of the loss of life that would happen both in the oceans and on land. In short, even if it landed in the oceans, we'd be screwed. Then, of course, if it straight up hit on land, there would be nothing to soften the blow, and the explosion of heat that would be caused by the impact would wipe out anything within an incredible radius. We're not talking a few miles or even a few hundred, we'd be talking thousands of miles, depending on where it landed. This would be worse than a nuclear bomb going off, or several of them going off right next to each other. So, needless to say, we wouldn't want either option to happen at all. Because of the threat this honestly causes humanity, many television shows and movies have tried to capture that fear and showcase how it can be handled. But that's where things get a bit tricky. Because in those shows and movies, they have time and resources to go and try to figure it out. And in many of those movies, they always find a way out of the situation, but for us in the real world, it wouldn't be easy. As we noted earlier, even if we have a warning about the comet coming, which sometimes we honestly don't because of the randomness of space and what comes close to the Earth, that doesn't mean we can do anything about it. Take this comet for example. You'd think that with it coming in 2031, that we'd have time to get everything worked out to destroy it, but it's not that simple. First off, if you want to destroy it, you'd have to reach it. But given our current technology levels, that's not really a feasible option because we needed to get closer in order to deal with it in a more efficient manner. You might think, can't we just attach a nuke to a probe and fire it at the comet? No, that wouldn't work. Even the most powerful nuke we have likely wouldn't destroy a comet 62 miles wide. What's more, there's a risk that even if it did shatter it, that the pieces would still fall towards Earth, which would mean all of a sudden that we'd have several comets heading our way instead of just one massive one, and even smaller comets can do greater damage. Plus, that's a big risk on various levels just on the Earth side of things. Because if a single thing does go wrong at launch, a nuke is going off Earth's side, and that is good for no one. Redirection is often something that is discussed in movies and such to go and keep things like meteors away from us. The problem with that is similar to the nuke problem, though. You'd have to go and get something to the comet to push it away, and then it would have to be powerful enough to actually go and push it away. Not an easy thing by any metric. In truth, a comet or meteor coming to our planet and hitting it is honestly a worst-case scenario that we can't overcome or plan for at present. because we just don't have the means or resources to try and do anything about it. And even if we did, it's not exactly something we can test until we honestly have a problem. Thankfully for us, it's not very likely that a comet or meteor of great size will be coming to hit us anytime soon. Sure, that could be a wrong assumption, but it's also true that nothing of this comet size has hit Earth in a very long time, depending on what you believe. See dinosaur extinction. So until it does happen or threatens to happen, we shouldn't worry about it too much. Thanks for watching. What did you think of this look at the comet that could be a planet killer that is heading towards the Earth right now? Are you shocked that such a thing exists in our universe and is heading our way? Do you think we have nothing to worry about overall? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.